Welcome, everybody. My name is Frank Schwarzenau. I'm the Partner Practice Lead for Observability and the leader for the Cloud Operations Competency. I'm here, joined here by Mission Cloud, with Shannon and Erin. Maybe a quick intro would be great.
Hi, I'm Shannon Smith. I'm the Vice President of Professional Services for Mission Cloud.
Hello, I'm Erin Coleman. I am VP of Managed Services for Mission Cloud.
Great. And we have you here because you're a launch partner for the Cloud Operations Competency. AWS launched this competency in April of this year, and we're happy to have you as a launch partner. So I want to thank you for the commitment to the AWS partnership and for working with us even before we launched this competency to help us figure out all of the hoops that we eventually make you jump through in the end. So I really appreciate it. At this point, I just want to quickly share of how AWS defines cloud operations. So cloud operations is for us is an integrated operational model that includes cloud financial management, governance, observability, compliance, and centralized ops management. And we validate our competency partners like yourself among those. So I was just curious for the definition of cloud operations of how Mission Cloud thinks about cloud ops and whether the definition is in line with what AWS is defining it as.
Since we're a cloud operations partner, competency partner now, we actually define it across all of our teams. It's everything that we deliver within Mission Cloud. So it starts with our managed services, and then it's extended through our professional services.
Yeah, so several of the different aspects, the components of the competency that you discussed, and you know, the reason that Shannon and I partner so closely together, we really come together bringing a full team experience across all of those competencies to make sure that we're delivering to our customers.
Yeah, perfect. And in AWS, we love to talk about superpowers, right?
Yes.
What are the superpowers?
And
for anybody who's watching this, it would be really interesting. Maybe you can share some of the superpowers that Mission brings to market.
So at Mission Cloud, we combine platform, people, along with passion to deliver transformative value to our customers. And we really do this with customers through each step of their AWS Cloud journey. We strive for excellence in each and every interaction that we have. So on a daily basis, we're looking at, and when I say daily, I really do mean daily. We're looking at CSAT, we're looking at NPS, so customer satisfaction, net promoter scores, to ensure that we are on the pulse of the customer for what they need for today. We also have a level of depth and breadth across teams, that whether that's cloud analysts, cloud engineers, solution architects, consultants, all coming together to understand the customer's business strategy and their roadmap for the future as well, keeping our finger on the pulse for the future of what our customers will need to. Now you asked about a superpower. I would say that is more of like this special sauce, secret recipe, but really it's our dedication to our customers that really sets us apart. And also our internal culture, where we have core values that you know we don't just talk about, but we do walk the walk every day. So accountability in action, being inclusive, embracing life, continuous growth, all of these things come together to empower the teams to deliver high-value services to our customers. And I'll wrap with another thought. Representation, we feel, is so important at Mission. So ensuring that we have all people at the table, all people represented. We're proud to share that you know this year we've still room for improvement, but we've grown to 43% gender diversity across our people managers and 38% across racial and ethnic diversity for our people managers as well. So we're getting closer to that full representation and being able to really harness and build on that momentum for the services of the future.
That's awesome. It sounds so good. And honestly, if I may say so, I love working with your team. You are really excited, not just for your customers, but also for the AWS relationship. So I appreciate all of that you've done for this relationship. So looking ahead a little bit, right? What are some of the key trends that you see that you're excited about?
Ooh, there's so much excitement happening this year around, of course, Gen AI. That's the big topic that everybody's talking about these days. We're really excited about how a lot of the new AWS technologies are playing into this space and giving so much more opportunity. There was the announcement of Q, Amazon Q, Bedrock, SageMaker, Code Whisperer. It's going to be really interesting to see how we can help customers utilize all of those tools to help them realize all the initiatives they're looking to achieve with Gen AI. You know, customers are really trying to figure out, I feel like it's two paths that they're going down. So one path is, how do we take the data that we have and harness it in a way that we can create products for our customers, we can do more with our business, we can make money off of that. How do we use that data and how do we use these tools for that? That's one path I've been seeing. And then another path I've been seeing is, you know, how do we use these tools to become more efficient, to get better at what we're doing for cost savings? And ultimately, I think cost savings is generating a lot of this. There's this big push right now for cost savings.
Absolutely. Yeah, with the macroeconomic conditions that we've experienced, I mean, cost savings has been a trend, and I don't think it's going out of style anytime soon. So we're super excited about cost optimization, the hub that came out earlier this week, and you're really kind of honing in on what value that can bring to our teams to be better informed and also to our customers as well.
Yeah, and cloud financial management is one of the five solution areas, right? So what we recommend and what, you know, partners like Mission does is integrate that into the operational model, right? It's not every size or every financial exposure fits every customer. So it always is depending on what the customer needs. So it's great to hear that this is part of your overall value prop. So we talk a little bit about trends. I'm super curious, what kind of solutions do you bring for to your customers?
So we have Cloud Foundation, which is around cost and infrastructure optimization, where we bring an expert team of cloud analysts to help customers realize immediate cost savings, and then also to help them grow and scale over time and reinvest that money they save as over time, like a continuous engagement type of model. Now for Mission Cloud One, that's our 24/7, 365 monitoring. And that is where our customers, maybe they're, you know, taking care of business strategy, they're on vacation, whatever it is, we are keeping a watchful eye over their environment. We're responding proactively to any incidents that come through. We're making sure that patching and maintenance stays on schedule. And making sure that if there's anything going on in the environment that they need to know, that we are reaching out to let them know. But not too much, right? Only what they absolutely need to know. We're trying to take care of, you know, the heavy lifting. So those are the two core service offerings. But for customers that want to go deep into modernization, and maybe there are some technical specialties or services, that's where Shannon's team comes in professional services, and they take it leaps and bounds further. So I'll hand over to you, Shannon, to share a little bit more about that.
In our professional services team, we have really three different practice areas that we offer. Migration and modernization, and with that team, we have cloud solutions architects and DevOps, CloudOps engineers that can help not only help design the infrastructure, help the planning, but also help build it, do the build out. So we have that team, and they're going to help with optimization, migrations, security remediation, kind of you name it, they can help with. Then we have our app dev team. And our app dev team is going to help with the application side of the code side of the business. And then we have our data analytics and machine learning team. Now here's where that's where all the excitement is right now. We've got our Gen AI consultants, our big data consultants, our big data engineers. And then across all of it, we've got our engagement managers that really are the glue that hold everything together, that help make sure that our projects run very smoothly and that we're staying on budget, on track, on time. And then within that, we have different ways that we can do business with customers to meet them whatever they need, wherever they are in their cloud journey. So some customers really just want us to do all the work. We can do that for them. Some customers, they may want us to bring them along, and so maybe they want something like paired programming, and we can do that with them as well. And other customers, it might be that they've got a team, but they're just looking for some experts in the industry to come in and help guide them where they're at. So we have a variety of ways that we can help.
So you're the one-stop shop, essentially.
We are the one-stop shop.
No, but I have to say, anybody that I've spoken to, really high caliber people. So I'm really impressed with the kind of caliber of people that you bring to the conversation that I have. So that's really cool. So in AWS, we are a very data-driven company. So I go on my system and I see all the deals that you're working on, all the great things, all the customers that you're working on. But maybe for some people that are watching here, could you share a little bit about some cool customer engagements that you've recently done that you're excited about?
Yeah. I'm really excited about the work we've done with Magellan TV. Now, Magellan is a customer that is very similar to Netflix, but they do documentaries. And they were looking to go internationally, which means that there's a need for translations. And also, if you think about it's video, so they've got to do dubbing of audio over video as well. And there's some inherent challenges with that. So not only do they need to have quality translations, they also need to have, when you're doing the dubbing, you want to make sure that the audio is overlaying nicely with the video. And they've also got to be able to replicate it in multiple languages. So we were able to work with them and utilize technologies like Poly, Translate, Bedrock, Titan, all of those to help create a solution for them that was able to do things like not just the translations, but take it even deeper. If you think about idioms, where we might use the term like "I hustle," and it was first translated. I don't remember the exact translation, but it was something like "I'm lazy," which is not what you want, right? So we were able to use the idiom detector to translate that to "I work hard." So it's much more accurate. So that's one piece of it. And then another piece of it is if you think about the length of a sentence. So if a sentence in English that's maybe 10 words, in German could maybe be 15 or, 16, whatever words, so much longer. And that creates a problem with video. So you want to be able to translate that sentence and shorten it, but still maintain the quality of the translation and the integrity of the translation. So we were able to work with them, and their initial cost for the dubbing was $18 per minute. We were able to get it down to $1.02 per minute. So that's a 99%+.
That's awesome.
Cost reduction.
Cool.
That was really exciting.
And one more cool thing about Magellan, our cloud analyst team that I mentioned earlier worked with Magellan on a three-tier application. Another one of the trends that we're seeing in the operational spaces around event management and application management as well, APM. And so we were able to actually work with them to provide recommendations for at reInvent so that their events go off without a hitch. And we are seeing more and more customers wanting to make sure of that. So just wanted to tie
awesome.
That in. Not
yeah,
only
cool.
did Shannon and team do all that
so
great work.
So anybody that's watching here, where can they find more information about what you just talked about?
missioncloud.com is always a good place to go.
Oh, but also missioncloud.com/AWS Marketplace. There you can find all of our service offerings on there. And what I'm really excited about is there's offerings in there for folks that maybe just want to talk to a consultant, get it, just a little bit of more insight as it relates to their business. You can do that through the marketplace. So
that's cool.
Yeah.
Awesome.
And there's a new feature out called Mission Cloud Score, which actually allows customers to go in and see how well they're executing against the AWS well-architected framework. You can look at some historical data and trending. That's available in the marketplace. Highly recommend. And if you click a button, you can talk to a cloud analyst as well. So that's a great way to get connected
so cool.
with Mission.
That's awesome. Yep. Well, thank you so much. Thanks again for being a launch partner for the competency. And thanks for talking with me.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.